What's this? An after-dark game of hide-and-seek? A treasure hunt? Well, actually, it is a hunt for living treasure.
So is it fun looking for puffins?
Yeah.
Earlier tonight, the whole gang gathered to make preparations. This group and other volunteers are the Puffin Patrol in Witless Bay on the Irish Loop south of St. John's.
And the key issue is really, let's dim down unnecessary lights. That is the most important message, because when the birds have no lights, their chances are great that they're not coming on the streets.
The organizer of the Puffin Patrol is come from away, Juergen Schau.
These are the boxes for the puffins.
He and his wife, Elfie, first came to Newfoundland from Germany 13 years ago.
It's garbage, you sing at the bird, but it's garbage.
He started his nocturnal Puffin Patrol 4 years ago.
And there was always light during the whole night here. You see that one here. And I talked to the town of Witless Bay, and they closed that down, the light. So now we found no dead ones here on the road.
Every night for a month, this year through September 20th, Juergen recruits parents and their kids to drive along the highways and byways of Witless Bay, looking for lost and disoriented baby puffins.
The response is really great from the community. I'm very proud about that.
Pufflings, as they are known, leave their burrows for their very first flight at night. They come from Great Island, a couple of kilometers offshore, which is part of the Witless Bay Ecological Reserve. They are seduced by the lights of the town. They fly in, get lost, or worse.
There's still this light on here on the ice hole, Southern Shore Arena. Who is responsible for this? Because I want to talk to somebody who might...
Tonight, Dina Wiseman and her kids make a puffin rescue.
Where did you find it?
By the fish plant.
On the fish plant?
On the fish plant.
We meet at the garage and then we can see the puffin, all right?
The fuzzy.
Yeah.
The Puffin Patrol has rescued up to 20 of these pufflings in a single night.
So you can see it has a black beak and dark feet.
Yeah.
Different from the adults.
Back at Juergen's garage, Puffin Patrol headquarters, one lucky little puffling is tucked away for the night.
Good night, little puffin, and tomorrow you will have a great first day of your life.
It's not always such a happy story. During the day, Juergen often finds other puffins on the Witless Bay roads who are not so lucky.
That was it where it all began. I saw them dead on the street and I was wondering what happened, why is it? And then you start to educate by yourself. And now we have a puffin patrol here in the community, and we save them. Not all of them, but most of them, which is good.
Witless Bay is home to the largest colony of puffins in North America, 250,000 breeding pairs. Juergen and his puffin patrollers believe that special measures need to be taken to protect this natural national treasure of life.
Puffin Patrol now on Molly Barn, our favorite one.
As a special treat for a job well done, Mike Shortle, skipper of the Molly Barn, has offered a free boat ride to the Puffin Patrol volunteers.
All of them too.
During the daytime, thousands of baby puffins are in their burrows here on Great Island. They're safe unless they poke their noses out.
Because when they're coming out to the end of the burrow, that's when they're accessible to the gulls and eagles. And when we passed Great Island there, we saw an eagle land on the grass and stick its head into her burrow. And I'd say if he didn't get a puffin chick, it's because he just missed.
When the sun goes down, the young ones will venture forth to test their wings. The highlight, and what makes all the time and effort worthwhile, is the morning release of each rescued puffling. By tradition, the kids give each puffin a name. And now Sam the puffling happily scoots back into his native element. For NTV News, I'm Steve Thompson in Witless Bay.